Hey guys, it's Shalise from Living Color Duct Tape and Remember When Designs, and I'm here to show you a mini wallet, or rather do a tutorial on a mini wallet. So we're going to use the Avengers tape, and I already have my credit card pockets and ID cut out. If you watched my last time lapse for my Kickstarter video, you saw me cut them out there. They are cut to 3 3/4. Two pieces of tape stuck together. I chose white. I have a 1/4 inch border on each one. And my ID is cut to 3 3/4 by 2 1/4, I believe. Yes, 2 1/4 white trim on that as well. So the only thing I need to make is the money pocket. And so that's what I'm going to do. I forgot to say, for the tutorial, you're going to need at least 2 colors or patterns of tape. You're going to need a ruler, an X-Acto knife, possibly some scissors, and a cutting mat. So I have these little pieces that were left over from lining up the tape, so I'm going to go ahead and use these to make my money pouch. So what you want to do, why doesn't camera always do that? Put some color in there. All right. So what you want to do, and I think I'm going to zoom in for this one because I don't need the full board. That's in. All right. You're going to cut out 3 pieces of tape that is 3 3/4 long. So 1, 2. And this is a great thing to do with all the, when you're lining up tape and you have those pieces left over that aren't quite 8 9 inches. So you can't really, you know, use it on the outside of a wallet. It's great to make more credit card pockets or put them together, make pens, what have you. So we're going to go ahead and take this piece here. So it's cut to roughly 3 3/4. And I'm going to take this and line it up with this 1/4 inch mark right here. Just so it's barely any on there. I'm going to lift it up and fold it in half. So I want to try to line it up to where the other side is. So something like that. Then you take your other piece that's already cut and put it right on top. So we now have our money pocket. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is cut the base of the mini wallet. Now this is not a smallet. It's a mini wallet. So the smallets have billfold. My mini wallets don't. I just don't see the point. My personal preference, whatever. So you're going to take a strip and cut it at 6 inches. Take another strip, cut it at 6 inches, but you want to line it up with the 3. So, okay. So we start here. You want to go up 3 inches and 3 3/4 inches, and you want to line it up with that line. And sometimes I go a little under the dots because Duck Brand lately has been making their rolls a tad short. So I want to make sure that they overlap. And then I'm going to take just 2 pieces of white tape that are 3 inches. So I'm going to basically make 1 piece and cut it in half. Okay, I'm going to start on this side. So this side is where I'm going to put my money pouch. And I'm just, what I do for my mini wallets, I just automatically cut about 1/8 of an inch off so it doesn't stick over on my money pocket and my credit card pockets, because I don't want to fight with the sides when I am putting it all together. All right. So you want to take your money pocket with the rounded edge up. And you can't see that. So let's see. Let's go up a little bit. There we go. You want to line it up with the bottom. And then you want to take your ID plastic and line that up with the bottom as well. And then put a piece of scrap tape on it to secure it down. On your other side, I go about a half, about 3/4. Okay, so where this 3/4 inch mark is here, line it up about there and secure it down with your tape. And then what you can do to make sure they're going to be even is you can put your other two pieces on top of each other just to kind of get an idea of how much you need to space them out. I think about there is good. So you secure that second card down. And then line the third card pocket up with the bottom of your mini wallet here. And then you want to secure it with another piece of tape. All right, so that's done. You're going to go ahead and flip the entire piece over. So you're going to peel it up off of your workspace and line it up with your grid lines. Right about there. All right. Now we're going to make the outside cover. So you want about half an inch of extra tape around each side. So I'm going to go down half an inch here, and I always cut over a half an inch on my sides so that I can trim it down to be exact. So see here, it's not exactly a half an inch, it's a little over, and I'm going to cut that the same way on this side. And let me see if this piece I have here, nope, it's not long enough. All right, so let us now find, okay, looks like it lines up right about here. I'm sorry this is taking so long. A lot of people don't take the time to line up during tutorials, but I sell my stuff every week at markets, so I'm not going to make something, take the time out to make something for a tutorial that I can't even sell. So that's just me. And that might line up. Let's see. It goes over pretty far. We'll see. So cut that off. And which one are we going for now? We're going for you know, I'm going to go ahead and use that piece there because then I only have to cut one more piece and it might fit a little better. So I'm just going to take that piece I cut off the side and line that up. And instead of lining up, see here it's about, let's see, an inch and a quarter of tape showing. This one's only about a half an inch. But it's fine because then when I lay this one down, I might just get that half inch over, huh, a little more. But it works out either way. So you can line it up at either spot. That's one good thing about this Marvel tape. There's a couple of different lineup points. All right, so that is done. Then, now remember, this is not 3 inches in width, it's 3 3/4 in width. So to get a half inch, you want to cut it at the 4 1/4 mark. I have made the mistake cutting it at 4 1/2, just thinking, you know, a half inch above. And have had to go back in and cut it over. So you cut it out the quarter inch, not the half inch. And then go ahead and trim up your sides. Let me peel this whole piece up and cut out your little triangles. Mine are triangles. I cut them at an angle. It just looks a lot neater when you're done if you cut them at an angle. I've been doing this for years. And people would always ask me, why don't your ends fold over? And I wouldn't tell anyone until now. So, okay, so then you want to just make sure that your pockets are straight. And this one's a little crooked, so let's pull it up. I think that's as straight as it's going to get. All right, and then you fold over your bottom. Like that. Check that side, fold the bottom over there. At this point, if you want to go ahead and cover the bottom here, you can. With my mini wallets, I don't even bother. So, and then fold up your sides. Like that. Then you can go ahead and remove your tape that's holding everything in. And cut your slits for your pockets. Be very careful when you're cutting out your money pocket and your first credit card pocket, because remember, there's only two pieces of tape there. So if you cut through, you're cutting through the entire wallet. I think I got all of them, so go ahead and fold those in, or however you cut. If you cut straight across, that's fine. I also cut my pockets at an angle so I can round them off. And a piece of white string here I need to get. I didn't even do the side. Oh my goodness. All right, and so I don't forget, I'm going to go ahead and put my card in like I do in all my wallets, and you are done. You fold it in half and press it. And you have your mini wallet. Ta-da! So, I hope this helped. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Like it, favorite, comment, whatever. And yeah, hopefully I'll be coming up with some more tutorials within the next few months. I've been super, super busy getting my business going and selling at markets, and it's been very, very crazy, but I'm hoping to get more tutorials out to help fellow duct tapers. And my next video is going to be my crafts for the week, so stay tuned.